this massive spike led to this massive increase in hospitalizations, as well as people going to ICU units. And so actually the worst is yet to come as we work our way through that massive increase.
The outlook for COVID-19 pandemic, as it's specifically affecting Texas, is pretty dire right now, but that doesn't mean to say that we can't turn that around.
One solution doesn't fit all across our state, and that's really the same case in the United States as well. You know, the pandemic is hitting different communities in different ways at different times.
I think we need to work on consistent messaging associated with wearing facial coverings, you know, maintaining social distancing, limiting your interactions with others, and just really trying to make yourself and those around you as safe as you can.
It's not going to go away, and we cannot stay locked up forever. And so we still have some learning to do of how we're specifically going to learn to live with the virus in a safe way. We haven't quite figured that out.
What we really need to do now is proactively test, including individuals who don't have symptoms, individuals who may be infected but don't yet have signs of illness, because every individual starts COVID-19 without showing any signs, but quickly becomes infectious. We need to know who those people are so that we can help them to know to isolate.